Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down, and we are still in the middle of Star Wars week. It drops Friday, December 18th.
Well, Thursday, I'm seeing it early because I'm a big fan.
Whoa! Yeah. How are you seeing it early?
Well, I bought tickets.
Oh, like 17. Months in advance.
Months in advance.
How early did you buy them?
Months in advance. Whenever they went on sale a few months ago.
Jeez,
did you? All the movie sites crashed and I got four.
You got four?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, and then this week I went to go see Creed at the theater that I'm going to see Star Wars. And when I used my credit card, Star Wars tickets printed out. And I was like, oh my God. And I was like watching the movie and they were in my pocket. And I was like, stay here.
Just
like,
terrified.
Like, what if they fall out?
Why did they print out?
I guess because like I had already bought them and they're like, your previous purchase is printing. I'm like, previous purchase. And they came out like,
dude, what if somebody would have seen that and just tried to like snatch them from you?
Because those are going for, you know, big money.
Yeah.
I think.
Would you sell your tickets?
No.
Didn't somebody sell theirs for like thousands of dollars?
I'm sure they did, but I'm not selling it.
There's no amount.
No amount.
So if someone walked in here and said, I'll give you $50,000 per ticket.
Well,
so that's an amount.
I guess, but no one's going to do that.
I mean,
I'm sure you can see
I'll make sure to air this one before Thursday.
Oh, did I ruin it?
No.
Okay.
No, I'm just saying, so like if someone does want to do that
right.
And they watch it and they contact you, you can hit them up on Twitter.
Yeah, at Zack Ryder.
All right. So again, to go along with the week, we're just playing Battlefront, getting some stuff in there. So we're going to do some survival stuff. So all we play as a team.
Okay.
I played on Endor with Big Wool, Big E.
Okay.
So is there any of these that suits your, that tickles your fancy?
We can do Hoth.
Okay, solid. And then if you get X.
Oh, this is going to be a disaster.
One more time. We're on the same team, so we're solid. So we're literally just staying in a little area, and then guys are going to come and try to kill us. But more importantly, we're going to talk about how much you love Star Wars.
Okay, who are we playing as? Just random dudes?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know anything. No, we're not Han and Luke.
That sucks.
I'm pretty sure it's random dudes. I don't know like anything story-wise about this game.
Oh.
Literally, I played the beta, and then I just got this yesterday. So I played like a little bit, but I'm like, I got to film. I don't know what's going on. Which is great. Gaming channel, don't know anything. I've done some research.
I mean,
if you have a pretty vast knowledge of Star Wars, correct?
See, I don't know if I can do like trivia, you know, but like I love Star Wars. I enjoy the movies. I collect the stuff. I'm going to see the movie. But if you like ask me all these like random questions that are like trying to stump me, like I probably won't know. Like I don't know, like, you know, the diehard nerds.
Like like Stardust stuff.
He knows, I don't even think he knows. Actually,
he thinks he's making stuff up.
He says I'm not a real Star Wars fan because I call it Episode 7, and he refuses to call it Episode
7. Yeah, he does.
Yeah. Technically, it is Episode 7.
Technically, but like
the Force Awakens.
Yeah. So, how do you feel about the originals up against the prequels?
Prequels suck.
All of them.
I just watched them on the last European tour.
Oh, we talked about this.
Yeah.
In your episode, yeah.
And then even the scenes that they've added into the original, they suck.
They're just no good.
They suck. How do we do this? Do we shoot?
You shoot with R2.
You probably should explain. R2-D2?
Yeah.
Ah.
I got him.
Oh, yeah.
If you hold L2, then you'll aim.
Okay.
And then you can still shoot while you're aiming. It helps you out a little bit. You can see a little better. And they're behind us. Turn around, there's some guys. It'll go and got him for us. It's all good. Okay, so you're going to see the movie.
Yes.
Are you dressing up?
No, I'm going to wear like some Star Wars like merchandise and stuff like that. And maybe like bring my lightsaber, take a picture in the parking lot, but that's about it.
So like you're going to tailgate?
I'm going to get there a little early for sure. Absolutely. I got the Star Wars inspired wrestling gear that I should have. I had it last week. I had it on. And then I decided, it's too early. I'm not going to wear it.
Why?
And then this week, of course, I have nothing. And then next week, I'm going to be in in London for NXT. So I think this right now. I'm in London.
Right now, you're in London.
I'm in London, so I wasn't at Raw or SmackDown. So I'm like, when am I going to wear this stuff? So maybe I'll go to the movie.
You can wear it on the NXT tour.
No, because I'm hype bro, so I got a match.
You got hype bros don't have Star Wars gear?
No.
You haven't convinced Mojo to do that?
Not yet.
Soon.
So yeah, that's my big like, damn, you know, like one of my biggest regrets in my life is not.
Do you have it with you right now?
I mean, it's my bag.
Do you want to go put it on?
Put it on?
Yeah.
No.
We can play like it.
I can go get it, but I'm not putting it on.
Yeah. What's it look like?
Should I go get it?
Yeah, yeah. Right, I'll pause it. Okay. Quick pause. Mike gets his gear. Real excited. Okay, so he's got his Star Wars themed wrestling gear.
All right, so when you first look at it, you might not know it's Star Wars, but you have to be a big Star Wars fan.
That's nice. You know? It's the galaxy.
The galaxy?
Yeah, the stars and stuff.
Oh, right. It's the stars, and it's like the Galactic Empire logo with the ZR in there. And then the side pieces are like the Rebel Alliance logo, like looped.
Mm-hmm.
And then the back is kind of like the Star Wars logo, but it's my logo.
I like that.
See, yeah. And then the knee pads. But I don't know when I'm ever going to wear them.
I feel like even if you're doing Hype Bros, you've got to wear it at least.
Oh, no, I'm definitely going to wear it, but I wanted to wear them like this like month, you know?
But I'm saying, like, because are those going to be televised at all?
Yeah. But we got to match. Like, you wouldn't wear a different gear than, like, Kofi and E.
If it's Star Wars time, I might.
I don't know. We'll see.
Like, if anyway. They're making a White Chicks 2 and I had White Chicks gear, then maybe I'd rock that.
My controller got unplugged.
That's fantastic. That we won't see before the movie. But after the movie.
After the movie, yes. Hopefully.
Fingers crossed.
Are
you doing anything else special for it?
Not really. I mean, I'm very excited, you know?
Yeah. Have you... Okay, so you said you rewatched them in
Europe. Rewatched all six.
Are you going to rewatch them again, like, this coming week?
No, I just rewatched them.
But that was, like, weeks ago.
It was close enough.
But you watched them by yourself, too. Are you going to watch them with the people that you're going with?
No, no, that's up to them.
Okay, yeah, so you're not sure if they've watched them?
I mean, I don't care. This is my...
It's for you.
You know? I'm very, very excited. I think it's going to be great. I like J.J. Abrams. He did great stuff for Lost, and
dude, you know, Lost is so good.
George Lucas kind of lost it, you know. You know what I'm saying? Like, what, those prequels were horrible.
But it's his world, you know.
I understand. It's his thing. You can do what he wants, fine. But now,
give it to somebody else.
Yeah, give it to someone who's gonna, you know, do some good.
Didn't J.J. Abrams make a? He did a bunch of TV shows. Did he do X-Files? Who's
X-Files? No,
who did X-Files?
I don't know.
You never watched X-Files?
No.
Dude, that show is amazing.
Are they bringing that back?
Yes, and I'm like losing my mind over it. I love X-Files.
I love David Duchovny.
He's great.
From Californication.
I've never watched Californication.
That's not like X-Files.
It's a little different.
Yeah. But, yeah, Star Wars, it's going to be insane. It's nuts. And then, like, all the Disney stuff. Like, I love Disney, so, like, Disney's a part of it. Like, they're not going to mess this up. They can't.
They can't. Then again, don't say they can't.
Right. I was going to say, then again, I thought that episode one was going to be amazing, too.
Yeah.
And boy, did that suck. You know?
It's just so wild to me. So, like, you said you bought tickets months in advance.
Right.
Like, and then these people that are buying the tickets for outstanding amounts of money, like, the movie's going to be there, like, the next day.
Right, but you don't want to get spoiled, you know? Like, that's why, like, I bought, like, 7 o'clock showing because I didn't want to get, like, the 9:30 and, you know, be walking out as people, or be walking in as people walking out.
Okay.
Like, did you see that? So-and-so died.
Gotcha.
Don't wanna, you know.
Yeah, okay.
You know, someone's going to die. You know. You know that. Come on.
But what if they don't?
I mean, I hope no one dies.
What if they
dies,
don't?
You know?
And people have been saying that. Honestly, someone's going to die.
I think Han's done.
You think it's going to be Han?
Or Chewbacca or both. I think they're designed.
I was going to say, if Han goes, Chewbacca has to go, doesn't he?
They go, like, together. So I think the Millennium Falcon, like, blow up or something.
That'll be too sad. You know? What is it? Somebody was saying something about being sad about death in Star Wars, or like a fictional character, and this is the only time this many grown men are ever going to cry at once.
Well, because, yeah, it's a fictional character, but you've been like, okay, I only started watching Star Wars when the re-releases came out in, like, the mid-90s. So these people have been watching since they were little kids in, like, the 70s and stuff.
Yeah.
So, like, it's been with them their whole lives, you know?
It's their thing.
Right.
They're Cory and Topanga.
I guess, yeah.
Oh, what happened?
I'm dead. What do I do? Play back?
Yeah. This thing is going to kill me. I hope it doesn't get to the point where... I don't know if I'll be able to deal if Chewie dies.
I'm going to Disneyland on a New Year's, and they have this Star Wars, like, launch bay thing. It's like almost like a, well, I haven't been there, so I don't know, but I think it's like a little museum thing with, like, props and whatever. But anyway, at the end, you can go meet Chewbacca. But what if he dies in the movie?
But maybe that's them saying that he doesn't die in the movie.
Or, I don't know, what if this is, like, limited edition, like, you gotta go now to meet Chewbacca, and then he dies.
As soon as he dies, he's not there anymore.
You know, like, What do they do?
So are you going to go do that? Well, you can't do that before the movie.
Well, yeah, I'm going to do that on New Year's.
On New Year's. New Year's. But when does that, has that...
That's already, like, people that are there right now. People at Disneyland right now meeting Chewbacca.
So if he dies in the movie, if he dies...
What do they do?
Then Chewbacca's just not going to be there.
Or is Chewbacca like an actor and he's just dead in the movie? You know, the actor is there at Disneyland.
I feel like if he dies in the movie, then he's dead in real life, like wrestling. We're only one character.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, where do you draw the line?
Are there other roles that Chewbacca's in other movies? I haven't seen him in any other movies.
He's in that... Isn't he in that Star Wars Christmas special? You ever see that?
No.
Oh, man. It's like... I've never seen it either, but I've heard all of it. Didn't it air, and then George Lucas, like, banned it from ever being seen again?
What?
Something like that.
It's that bad?
Google it. I've never seen it.
I have to find it now.
But I have no idea how to say this.
It's all good. There's just guys over there, yeah.
My dad?
Just a little friendly chat. Yes. Oh, you went too far away.
Yeah, get out of here! All the Star Wars merchandise that's out now is like ridiculous.
Yeah, come on in,
so
go.
So many cool toys. What the hell? Go,
we're chatting some Star Wars.
Yeah, I'm trying to play this
game. Playing video games?
I was at Target the other day. They had this like 4-foot Darth Vader like action figure, and I was about to buy it, and I pressed the voice, like the try me button.
Yeah.
And it wasn't even James Earl Jones.
What? Like,
come on.
Who was it?
Some dude. Oh, you know? No, and I guess like they didn't get the license for it.
Nah.
So I'm like, I almost bought it. I'm like, I can't do that.
Gotta be James.
Too, yeah, right? Yeah. My son loved those. I was like, not even James Earl Jones. Let's get out of here.
That's like, I think my favorite James Earl Jones though is the one in Conan. This is power.
What about Sandlot?
Oh, I do like Sandlot. Oh man, James Earl Jones is just solid in everything. In Best of the Best? Oh my god. Okay. We're getting it. Hey, so he's gonna see Star Wars Thursday night.
Thursday night.
Midnight?
No,
7
p.m.
7 p.m.?
7 p.m. Wow.
Right?
I bought tickets. Kobe, did you buy tickets?
No,
you
don't. My life is not such that I can just go out and watch movies. I have family.
So it's not
I'm an adult.
This year, you know the expression, Peter Pan?
In that Geico commercial?
You know the expression, Christmas comes once a year. This year comes twice because Star Wars coming out and Christmas. So I'm celebrating Christmas with my family. I'm going to be with my family on Christmas and when Star Wars comes out. My cousin is driving from New Jersey to watch Star Wars.
Do you celebrate Christmas now? Because back in the day, you were surprised that I celebrated Christmas.
I'm just sure.
Why?
Talk about that?
Kofi.
Oh, okay.
Why weren't you sure if you celebrated Christmas?
Kofi's
you
a... Wanna, no.
You talking about this? Story here?
Let's not.
Okay. Hey, do you see Zach's Star Wars gear? Or excuse me.
It's Star Wars inspired.
Star Wars inspired.
Wait, what was your nickname?
Brett Mathews.
Brett Mathews.
Yeah.
I'm so bad at the nicknames. You see Brett Mathews.
Brett Mathews? Throwback?
Little throwback. We showed my tattoo on the last time.
BM.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Good little BM.
Yeah.
Nice. Well, guys, it's all good. We got through about 9 waves. Learned some stuff about Star Wars. Yep. Get excited. Always a hype, bro. You can get hyped, too.
May the force be with you.
And also with you.
Yeah.
Ah.
Right?
That was UpUpDownDown. Make sure you follow me on Twitter at Xavier Woods, PhD. Follow Brett Mathews on Twitter at
Zack Ryder.
Follow Mr. 24/7 on Twitter at
True Kofi.
Actually, I want to switch my name to Zack Daddy.
Zack Daddy?
Yeah.
Oh, so much better. Yeah. Big switch.
Zack Daddy.
So Zack Daddy. Yeah,
I like that.
Follow Zack Daddy. Yeah. ZE.
Can we do a graphic that says Brett Mathews in like a Ghostbusters thing and then it says.
Ghostbusters inspired.
Like, no ghost.
Inspired, not the actual full ghost.
Inspired.
It's copyright issues. Yeah. But I can come up with something.
I'm
editing this, so I'll try to get that in there for you. Zack Daddy.
I like that.
Can you go like punch to the camera and go Zack Daddy?
Yeah. Like Zack Daddy. Like that?
Yes. Perfect.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Make sure you like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Share with your family, your parents, your friends, everybody. But no matter the circumstances, make sure that you always and forever keep it tight.
As tight as possible.
See, he knows.
Tighter than the shirt.
Woo! That's tight.
It's pretty tight.
So tight. All right.